Well, this is the season for barbecuing. The barbecue becomes practically an extension of your kitchen, and it's there for much more than just burgers and steaks. Joining me is registered dietitian Andrea Hohlwegner. Andrea, thanks very much for speaking with us today. Now, we've had a bunch of really hot days in Calgary earlier this month, and we've got some heat returning. And, you know, it's just so comforting to have the barbecue outside so you cool down the house.
Absolutely. We're a huge fan of barbecuing and grilling in our home. We put just about everything on the grill. So I'd encourage you to just, you know, do a quick Google search about any vegetable, for example, and learn how to put it on the grill. It's the tastiest way to enjoy veggies and all sorts of great ideas to keep your house cooler.
Mm-hmm. Now we're going to start with the item on my right in the foil there. So you've got chicken with a bunch of vegetables.
You bet. So if you kind of take a peek at what I've got here, you're going to be able to see it's just chicken with some barbecue sauce. I've sliced up the carrots in little matchsticks, potatoes, onions. We've got some little mini zucchinis and red peppers. And the only thing you need to do there is just brush the chicken with some barbecue sauce, drizzle a little olive oil, salt, pepper around your veggies, wrap it up in a nice tight, fully secured tinfoil package and toss it right on the grill. So delicious and a really great make and take item if you're heading to a barbecue or maybe you're heading out camping.
And the chicken cooks just as well with the vegetables? Like it's not a timing issue where one needs more than the other?
The key is kind of slicing the carrots in nice little thin matchsticks, but it's actually pretty good. So, when you suspect it might be ready, because everyone's barbecues and campfires are different, you can, of course, use a thermometer if you really want to nerd out with
right.
this stuff. But definitely make sure your chicken is cooked. And I suspect your veggies will be ready just at that same time.
Sounds delicious. You even do pizza on the barbecue.
We do, because, hey, you got to have pizza in the summer. So if I walk you over to what I've got on this side here, take your pizza shells or your pizza dough. You can buy at the Italian markets in town. Slice up some fresh tomato. You can throw some basil on that if you've got some in your grill. A little olive oil. I'm going to put some olives on our pizza tonight that we're eating and some fresh olives. Just put it right onto the grill, and it's just an awesome way to enjoy fresh pizza in the summertime.
Mm-hmm. Skewers are also handy on the barbecue as well, and not just for meat. And you've got yellow cauliflower there.
I know. That's why I'm wearing my yellow shirt. I had to, make this segment very colorful. So, of course, cauliflower is typically white, but what we know, if you head over to the farmer's market, you're going to see all sorts of great heirloom-style vegetables. You're going to see the yellow cauliflowers, the purple cauliflowers, and some really great items you can toss on the grill. Things like beets, cabbage, corn on the cob, your small petit pan squash, carrots, all of these things work really great in grill baskets or in tin foil. So again, if you're looking to figure out how to grill a new vegetable you've never done on the barbecue, just do a quick search on Google and you're going to find all sorts of inspiring ways. And that grilling really brings out that nice caramelized flavor in vegetables. So it's my favorite way to eat veggies.
Yeah, sounds delicious. And finally, you've got a dip there, which I usually associate like with a Super Bowl party or a Grey Cup party. But this is something you can do in the summer on the barbecue, too.
Absolutely. And of course, this is something you could serve as an appetizer. I am going to serve it camping for lunch with some taco chips. What I've got in this recipe, and I do have the recipe up on my blog, it's healthstandnutrition.com if you want to grab the exact recipe, but I'll run you through what's in there. First of all, you're going to put some refried beans on the bottom layer of your dish. Then you're going to take a couple of avocados, the juice of some lemon, and a little Tabasco, depending on how spicy you like it. Mix that together and make that next layer. And then the upper layer is going to be your sour cream, some mayonnaise, all of your spices like chili powder, cumin, garlic powder, paprika, a little salt and pepper, and then you're going to top it off with a little bit of grated cheese. So when you heat this up on your barbecue, it's going to get all like warm and gooey and delicious. And then, of course, on top, some green onions, cilantro, and some olives, and you are set. So this is a fantastic lunch or even just kind of like a finger food supper meal out on the patio.
Oh, it just sounds absolutely delicious. We did show the recipe there for a minute, and we will give people the opportunity to find it again on your website. So, Andrea, thanks very much for joining us this afternoon.
Thanks very much for having us.
All right, enjoy your camping trip. And for more information and to find that recipe for the bean dip, visit healthstandnutrition.com. Andrea is also on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.